దేశంలో కరోనా పాజిటివ్ కేసుల సంఖ్య 84కు చేరిందని ప్రకటించింది కేంద్ర ఆరోగ్య శాఖ. వీరిలో 10 మందికి ఆరోగ్యం మెరుగుపడటంతో హాస్పిటల్స్ నుంచి డిశ్చార్జ్ చేసినట్టు చెప్పారు ఆరోగ్య శాఖ ప్రత్యేక కార్యదర్శి సంజీవ్ కుమార్. ఇరాన్లో చిక్కుకున్న మరికొందరు స్టూడెంట్స్ ఇవాళ రాత్రికి భారత్ చేరుకుంటారని చెప్పారు. అలాగే ఇటలీలో ఉన్నవారిని తీసుకొచ్చేందుకు స్పెషల్ ఫ్లైట్ పంపిస్తున్నట్టు తెలిపారు.
The government of India has taken a number of proactive measures such as travel restrictions, universal screening of passengers at entry ports, suspension of visas and self-quarantine measures to effectively contain, prevent and manage the spread of COVID-19. All essential facilities like community surveillance, quarantine, isolation wards, adequate PPEs, trained manpower, rapid response teams are being strengthened further in all states and UTs. To check the shortages and black marketing, the government has also declared masks and hand sanitizers as essential commodities under Essential Commodities Act up to June 30th. Under the Disaster Management Act, the states can now draw funds from the State Disaster Response Fund in addition to the funds from the state government and the NHM. A Mahan Air flight will be bringing back Indian passengers from Iran. The flight will land in Mumbai at midnight today. In addition, another special flight of Air India will be flying today to bring back Indian students from Italy. We now have 84 confirmed cases of COVID-19 in the country. Of these, 10 have fully recovered and discharged. Contact tracing of these cases has led to identification of more than 4,000 contacts who have been put under surveillance. The second case of death in the country is that of a 68-year-old female from West Delhi. It is reiterated that Indian nationals are strongly advised to avoid all non-essential travel abroad and refrain from traveling to countries reporting high cases and deaths as mentioned in our travel advisories. All incoming international passengers returning to India should self-monitor their health and follow the required do's and don'ts as detailed by the government.